Hi guys, welcome to Code Bashers. Today's question is best time to buy and sell stock. In this question, we are given an array for which the ith element is the price of the given stock on day I. If we are only permitted to complete at most one transaction, that is buy one stock and then sell one share of the stock only, then we have to design an algorithm to find the maximum profit. No, we have to note that we cannot sell a stock before we buy one. So let's look at an example. Suppose we are given an array. In this array, every index represents a number which is equal to the price of the stock on that day. Suppose the price of the stock on day 1 was 7, day 2 was 1, and day 3 was 5, and so on. So we have to maximize the profit. That is, we have to buy a stock at the minimum price as possible and sell the stock at the maximum price as possible. So now in this case, our output is 5, and the output is 5. How? Like, if we buy a stock on day 2, that is, we buy a stock at price 1 and sell the stock at day 5, that is at a price of 6. So our profit will be 6 minus 1 equal to 5. And we have to note that this case is not possible. That is, we buy a stock at price 1 and sell a stock at price 7, because we are not permitted to go backwards in days. Like, we are not permitted that we buy a stock on ith day and sell a stock on the days which are less than I. So in these cases we have to buy a stock and then only move forward in the array to sell the stock. We cannot move backwards. So we have seen this case. Now another example. In this case, the array which is given is decreasing. That is, if we buy on day 1 and sell on day 3, then there will be a loss of rupees 3. That is 7 minus 4, there will be a loss of rupees 3. So we do not have to do our loss, we only have to do our profit. So in this question, we are given that we have to complete at most one transaction. This means that we have a choice to not to do any transaction. So in this case, we will not do any transaction, because in every transaction we will configure a loss only. So now let's look at the approach of this question. So now what we have to do, we have to calculate the profit. Now what is the formula of calculating the profit? That is, the price of the stock on the ith day minus the min value of the stock till ith day. Means, suppose like we are at day 4, the price of the stock is 3. Now we have to sell the stock at this day. So what will be the profit? The profit will be the 3 minus the minimum value of the stock till this day, that is the fourth day, which will be equal to 1. So the answer will be 3 minus 1 equal to 4, or 3 minus 1 equal to 2. So 2 will be our profit when we will sell the stock at this day. Now suppose we are at this day, that is fifth day, we have to sell the stock on the fifth day, then what will be the profit we will be earning? That is the price of the stock on that day, that is the ith day, minus the minimum value of the stock till that day, that is equal to 1. So profit will be 6 minus 1 equal to 5. So the profit will be 5. So how we will do it? We will take two variables, that is int profit, which will be initialized with 0. We have to maximize this variable, that is, we have to maximize the profit. And another variable is min value, which will store the minimum value of the stock till the ith day, and it will be initialized with int max. So now first we will iterate our array, prices array, i less than prices dot size i++. Now first what we have to do, we have to update our min value. Min value is equal to min of min value comma prices at I. Now we have updated our min value first. Like before the traversal of the array, our min value was int max. Now when we have reached at index 0, that is the first day, then our min value will become, the min value till ith index will become 7 only, because we have traversed till here only one element. So now we have got the min value till the ith index. Now we have to calculate the profit. Profit is equal to max of profit comma what will be the profit? The price of the stock on the ith day minus the minimum value of the stock till ith day. That is, price of the stock at ith day minus the min value of the stock till the ith day. This min value variable will contain the minimum value of the stock till the ith day. Now we have to maximize this. So now we have iterated through all the array. So suppose at any particular time we are at this index, that is the fifth day. So the min value, first the min value will get updated. So the min value till now will be 1. So in this variable our currently min value is 1. And now the profit, how will calculating it? That is the price of the stock at the ith day, which will be equal to 6 minus the min value till the ith day, that will be equal to 1. So the profit will be, this value comes out to be 5, and this 5 value will be compared with the previous profit, and hence it will get maximized. In the end we have to return our profit. Now I will explain you with one more iteration. Like we are at this index, that is on our day 6, this min value will store the minimum value till this index, till the ith index, which is currently 5. We are on the 6th day. So our min value till now will be 1 only. And now we will calculate the profit we will be earning when we sell our stock on this day, which will be equal to the price of the stock on that day minus the minimum value of the stock till that day. That is, it will be equal to 1. So this value, price is I minus min value will for day 6 will be 3. Now this 3 will be compared to our previous profit, and our profit will get updated if current value is greater than the profit. So yes, this was the case, and in the end we have returned the profit. So now let's run the code. So it is accepting. So yes guys, it is accepting. I hope you liked the video. Thank you.